Hey everyone, welcome back to our video series. Today I want to talk about measuring your well casing. That's a critical part of your research as you start to look for a hand pump and as you start to fill out our quote form. So it's pretty straightforward. There's a couple different measurements that you could do. There's either a circumference measurement, which is measuring all the way around the casing, or there's an ID, which is the inside of the casing, or an OD, which is outer diameter. That's the outside of the casing. What we do suggest that in situations where you have your submersible pump coming through the pipe, through the cap out of the top, you can't get the cap off. It requires machinery and so forth because it's carrying the whole weight of your submersible. So in that case, we suggest that you use the circumference measurement. And the best way to do a circumference measurement is actually with a cloth tape like this. You just would take your cloth tape and come all the way around, and you can mark and see, well, you can see here that this is just under 21 inches. One tip that we do have when using a cloth tape to make it a little easier is you can put a little bit of tape on the cloth to make it easier to hold in place and then bring it right around. And as you can see, this is just under 21 inches. If you were to use a metal tape, you can get a measurement that's not quite accurate. As you can see, it starts to clump up. But here, you can see that you're looking at about 22 inches. So very much a difference if you do it this way versus with a cloth tape, which could make the difference between having the correct cap and having an incorrect cap. So we definitely suggest using a cloth tape. In the case where you have a pitless adapter on your submersible pump, you can actually remove your existing cap or your existing seal quite easily because it's just held on with a couple of bolts and nothing's really holding it down. And in that case, you would need to remove that cap and then you would measure from the top side both the inner diameter and the outer diameter and associate that to our list of options that we have in our form. All right, so when we're here, our inner diameter, our ID, is the inside of that casing material. So the easiest way is to put 1 inch on one side and then come across to the other side. Get it as close as you can. It's not going to be perfect, but as you can see here, we've got 7 inches minus the one that we started with. So this is a 6 inch ID or inner diameter casing. If you look at the outer diameter, you've got your one now on the outside of the casing material. And you look at the other side, it's 7 5/8, which you minus that one is now 6 5/8. So this is a 6 inch casing with an outer diameter of 6 5/8. Very standard size casing. So you get those two measurements, your inner diameter and your outer diameter. You're gonna have what you need in order to fill out our quote form so that we can select the correct cap for you.